So yesterday, I got a new tea pitcher, Kamjove Press Art Tea Cup. This is the box here. And here's the actual pitcher. And it works just like this one, which is the Ming Xiang one. But this one here, as you can tell, in size, is quite a bit bigger. But that's alright. This one here, I'm going to keep at home. This one here, I'm going to take to my folks' house. I go over there once or twice a week, help them out with chores and have dinner and all that. They're coffee drinkers and not tea drinkers, so I'm going to make a little, this afternoon, I'm going to make a little gunpowder tea from the spice merchant. Brewing some water up here, warm it up. It should be there in a second. It came with this nifty little scoop. So I've made gunpowder before a few times, and I like my gunpowder to be a little bit weak, so I don't need a whole lot. A little bit more than that, but not a whole lot. I'm going to do this one-handed with a camera in one hand. It's a trick. That's about right for my gunpowder, because like I said, I don't like it real strong. I found with these two types of infusing devices, the Kamjove here and the Ming Xiang, or the Ming Xiang cup, is that it takes it brews faster than a normal cups do, than my normal infuser. Still getting a little warm. Thing is, you can also take the top off and put that down, and you can hold it there without making a mess. This one here, the Ming Xiang, works on a ball bearing in there. And this one, the Kamjove, works on a O-ring style system. So I don't think either one's better or worse. Just different. That's all. I like them both. I like this one here because of the size. I'm actually thinking of ordering a one that's even a little bit bigger than this. Because in the morning, this is what I take to work with tea. Is this, and it's about 11 ounces. And it takes about 2 3/4 of that to fill that up. So, and then this here, you'll see how little it makes. It's a small one. Just about done. You know, this one here would probably take 2 of that one to fill this cup, and probably 1.5 to fill that cup, which is good for the green tea I'm getting ready to have here in a second. So put this over here. Add a little warm water. Nice thing about green tea also is it can seep more than once, whereas my black teas, usually after the second seeping, it gets a little too diluted for me, and I don't care for that. I like it a little bit. My third, like in this one here, if I do black tea, the third one is almost done for me. I mean, it's really about all it can take. Boiling now, so we'll turn that down. We don't want it to be at a full boiling boil. And you can kind of see the tea leaves are starting to unfurl in there, starting to turn a beautiful color. If anyone's had any experience with these, let me know if you also think the tea seeps faster than they do in your traditional tea ball or a tea style infuser that I have, like, over, I showed you in previous videos. I give it about a minute with the green teas, and I'll probably give it about a minute and a half or 2 minutes with a black tea or an Indian tea. I'm gonna add a little bit more water for one more on this one. And that should be enough after that one for my little cup here that I got pre-warming with some water here. Turn that off. Plug it there. Oh, get off there. I'm also thinking of buying from the same company a tea kettle that's a little bit better quality, bigger, and it actually is releasable from the base. That's a good looking color right there. So, and I've heard people say you can take the top off, put the strainer basket on that in the fridge, and you can steep a green tea or even an oolong later on in the evening or later on in the day if you wanted to, which sounds like a good theory to me, but I haven't tried it yet. I really like black tea, so I don't do a whole lot of other teas. I mean, I like oolongs and I like green teas, but I'm a big fan of black teas. I like Earl Grey a lot. Smells great. It's awesome. So, I'm going to try it out a few more times. And like I said, I'll probably take this one to my folks' house and keep this one and maybe get another bigger one of the same style for home here. And maybe in the future, a different kind of kettle. That one works great, so there's nothing wrong with it. You know, especially for the price, $9 at Dillon's or a Kroger store. Let's get tea. All right. Thank you, folks.